Where are we?
Son, doesn't say nerd talk.
Say nerd talk!
I may not be able to read, but that does not say nerd talk.
Oh, I know where we're at. We're on the set of Cards Subject to Change, another great show here on WeBeam TV. And you know what?
Who?
WeBeamTV.com.
No, the show? Who?
Cards Subject to Change. It's a little show, you know, a little crazy show. I got the scissors out my way. It doesn't bother me. Anyway, so Nerd Talk set is getting a kind of a makeover from Dan. And we were going to show pictures, but I decided not to. I think we should do a 100% complete reveal when it's completely done. Because a lot of the assets are still going to be on the set, but it's going to be some subtle changes and then one big blingy change, right?
Yeah.
Yeah. So this young man right here, and I say young because I'm old, and I'm probably not long for this world because I think all my employees are going to revolt and kill me in my sleep, probably, because I've been a pain in the ass this week. And I said ass. I owe a quarter for the jar, but I don't care.
Just wait till the set's done.
No, no, they won't wait till the set's done. They'll kill me the day before it's done, so I don't ever get to see it.
Oh.
It's been a rough week. It's actually been a rough couple weeks because we've been dealing with, we've been dealing with building issues, roof issues, ooh, water issues, heat issues, electrical issues, and it's just nuts, absolutely nuts. But Dan, tell us what you do for a living, because I find it very, 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 very cool, and I think it's very, very, very awesome.
Well, I work as a technical theater employee, so I do a lot of the backstage stuff. I predominantly do stage management. I do stage management, but predominantly I do scenic design.
So you're the guy that instead of a blank stage, you make the stage look either period or futuristic or black or whatever they need, right?
Yeah, usually I work most closely with the directors.
Right.
Because they usually have some form of vision in their own mind about with the blocking, where people are going to move on stage, how they're going to interact with one another. So I work very closely with the director and see, okay, when is it set? What kind of elements are you thinking? What's feasible with the budget?
Right. Well, and that's typically what really sets the stage.
Pun intended.
Is the budget.
Yes.
I mean, because a lot of times, you know, these smaller theaters, they want the Broadway look, but they've got the sidewalk budget. But I tell you, I've been to two shows here locally that the sets are absolutely phenomenal.
Mm.
I think the last couple we did at Suncoast Richie Theater,
yeah,
correct? One was You're in Town?
Yeah, I did. That was my first set there, which actually I had a lot of problems with getting with that one because I had some family problems going on.
Yeah.
So I spent like a week in a hospital bed, not me in the bed. But
yeah.
So it was right in between, and I was communicating with the director over there, and it was like, I'm sorry, I'm not in there. I'm having family crisis at the moment.
Yeah.
So that was.
And you've actually done a set here for us.
Yes.
On Thursday nights, we stream.
He's into wrestling.
We streamed D&D. Right, and it's I think the version now is
the island.
Yeah.
But before it was the arena.
Mm-hmm.
But if you ever watch the show, you can see the backdrop where we have it's a very taverny looking area where he's really kind of faux walls. Which I had people walk in and all, oh, well, I got brick on that, and then they'll go touch it. Well, that's not brick. That's paint. Yeah, that's paint. So, but it's very, very cool. And I think James has some pictures or some images of stuff that Dan has done.
Yeah, I have a few.
Show, look at there.
Oh, that nightmare.
Oh, is that a boat?
No, that is actually greased lightning that me and three of my coworkers built in 3 days. We built.
Is that the actual truck?
That's the almost finished product. We built that in
freaking awesome.
3 days.
What are they going to do with it when they're done?
Oh, it's been done. It's at Gulf Middle School.
That's pretty cool.
It was, we wound up working a 36-hour shift.
Oh, Lord.
Yeah. But
36
we,
hours.
We got it done for the first show.
That's it, absolutely fantastic.
Oh, yeah. The coworkers that I did it with are all incredible, too. They're really hardworking. I do predominantly at the Center for the Arts at River Ridge.
Okay.
Is where I do most of my work. And they're incredible hard workers. My very good friends, Daniel, Matt, and Justin, who Justin's actually getting ready to go to school. But that was an insane build that we're glad we did, I feel, but we would never do again.
James, getting more images to show?
Yeah, I got a boat.
Holy cow.
That I would think would be even harder than that car.
What was that show?
That was Peter Pan.
Peter Pan.
Nice.
That was my next one.
For yeah, a middle school.
How many days?
Actually, most of it, some of it was recycling from things we've done from other shows. The mast was from a production of Little Mermaid. The steering wheel was from another show. It's an actual steering wheel for a boat,
though.
So
it's a ship's wheel.
Yeah.
Got it.
So that wasn't a build that we did. Then the platform that it was sitting on was from another show, High School Musical, which was wonderfully fun to work.
So you're doing a high school musical in a high school.
Yeah.
Imagine that.
But most of what I do is for the school, so we know how much schools like supporting arts budgets.
Mm-hmm.
So a lot of it tends to kind of be recycling and how can we make this work, which can get a little frustrating. And even then, there are times when I volunteered my time to some of the schools.
Yeah.
For if there's enough of a time frame and it's a pivotal piece. Like there was a boat I did for Peter Pan, a smaller one, like a rowboat.
Right.
And I volunteered my time for it because they were not going to have one otherwise.
Oh,
and I was able to take my time enough with it that it was like, all right, I can put a little bit of time to this. I think I did it over like 4 or 5 weeks.
Wow. So. You and I have a lot in common, even though I'm twice your age. But all through high school and all through college, the one thing that I did get to work in is I was either performed or played in the band or was staged. I was always the audio or lighting guy. Now, I always got recruited to paint.
Everybody gets recruited.
Big stuff. They wouldn't let me do the fine detail stuff because I suck at fine detail. But I'm just saying, I mean, yeah, and yet here I am, a videographer and an editor, going, you know, fine touch is very critical in our industry.
Speaking of fine touches, we got this set here that looks really good.
That was Into the Woods, which I didn't get to build all of it. I got to help with the design of most of it because it was River Ridge High School, which is the campus my theater is located on. So
go back to that shot, James. Now, is that a flat in the back?
It is actually a backdrop.
It's a backdrop. Okay.
It is a backdrop. And then there's the trees in front of it are cut out and they're hung from pipes.
All
and
I know
they
is
were
that
painted.
One tree looks excited. I gotta point it out because I go in here and our viewers at home are like, dude.
Yeah, that was one that I designed and someone else had built because I just didn't have the time to be able to do, and it came out.
That was cool, actually.
It came out.
Yeah, it came out all right.
No, it looked great.
It did. What, did you get any more?
I got all kinds of things.
Ah, show us. Because I love this stuff.
Where he started the chair.
That was also for Into the Woods. That was
Is that electrical chair? I mean, is that like executioner's chair?
It actually becomes a throne.
Becomes a sweet little throne.
Oh, that
which
is
was
awesome.
So did you upholster it?
Yes. I actually took material, and I didn't like legitimately upholster it like an upholsterer would.
Right.
I think I used like super glue.
Oh, jeez.
Speaking of glue.
Oh, wow.
That is my pride and joy. That is the first prop I ever designed. It's a horse. It's kind of tough to tell from this angle.
No, I know exactly what it was.
But it's full-sized. It was also for Into the Woods, but he has been recycled for many shows. His name is Elmer. He's made from 15% recycled horse.
That is awesome. Oh, my God.
For those who don't know, glue used to be made out of horse hooves. It's a little bit of a morbid humor on my end.
That's funny, though. That's absolutely hilarious. Absolutely hilarious. I mean, that's dude, that's funny. So Dan has been building on the Nerd Talk set. Actually, and here's the funny thing. Once Nerd Talk set's done, he's got added touches to go to the card subject to change. Mm-hmm. and actually, and then on the main stage we have in here, we have a whole wall that's got to get built. He's a very busy boy.
Yeah.
But he does really, 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 really good work. And most people don't understand that in our industry, what you see is really not what it is.
No.
I mean, it may look like a concrete pillar, but it can be picked up by a four-year-old.
Foam. A great example for that was a set that I did actually for the first show we produced at the Center for the Arts, which was a production of Always Patsy Cline, which we're actually doing again in March, which it features all the music of Patsy Cline. It's really fun, but I built a fake stove out of foam board.
Oh, that's awesome.
It weighs like 3 pounds.
But a child could pick it up and throw it across the
yep.
room. That's it. Now, even the set here, this is not real brick. I mean, this is a brick fascia.
Mm-hmm.
That
what?
Been,
that's not
I
real
know,
brick?
I know.
Come on. Well, you've been lying to me this whole time?
Well, you know, I had to do that because I was afraid Mark might pick me up and do a wrestling move and throw me through it. And I've been hit by brick before, and that sucks.
I was going to say I thought you were scared because it's a wrestling show, and they might do the macho, oh, yeah, and then the Kool-Aid guy comes through.
Oh, well, that would be cool.
Oh, see, no.
Oh, no.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah.
Now, that would be kind of cool. Now that you said that, no, don't ever... Here's the problem, and Dan's learning this very, very quickly here, is if you show me something and you're not quite sure, and then my brain goes into overdrive, next thing you know, I'm like, well, we can always do this, and let's try this. This poor guy brought in this table, and I'm going to give this away, right? I'm not going to give everything away, but he brought in, we have a new table coming from Nerd Talk. And it was so cool that I'm like, you know what? I don't want to do this at the table now. I want to flip this over so everybody can see it, because I'm thinking, you know, even my buddy Ed was like, dude, this is really cool. But the problem is no one's going to be able to see it, you know, because we really don't do a lot of down shots,
mm-hmm.
you know, and it's more on and it was, and there's so much detail. So now poor Dan's got to take this and he's going to go this way with it and hang it and then create another table on top of that so people can actually see the Nerd Talk table. But that's how cool it was. And it's like, you know, then that's just kind of the way I'm, you know, that's the way I'm wired.
It's nothing. I'm used to working with teachers.
And
so,
you know, all it takes is this much. And then next thing you know, I'm running with it. So it is kind of what it is. So, you know, James, is there any more pictures? Oh, you know what? I think it's 7 o'clock.
No, it's not.
Oh, it's not. Oh, thank God, because we have another show that he has to start at 7 o'clock.
Oh.
We kind of run him ragged back there. Hey. He's by himself. Everybody's gone today. No Josh today. He's sick. Poor puppy. You know, I think I'll think he's sick. I think he has the Friday blues.
Maybe.
You know, Friday flu. So, you know. No, he looked pretty good.
Yeah.
He looked pretty dogged. So he does work hard. You know, they all work hard here. Everybody here, you know, I have to give my guys credit because they really do put in some serious hours and they get to deal with me. And just dealing with me part is probably taxing enough. But then
I thought that's what we got paid for.
No, really, it's not. I mean, that's just the extra cool stuff that you get. So
I'll introduce you to some school board members that are going to make you look like easy.
I'm running your show.
I'm going to run the show. And see, we can jump on stuff.
I mean, I totally just not let you, you know, but that's your client. You got to deal with that tomorrow morning.
Yeah, anyway. So, James, give me some other shots that we did, that Dan's got going on.
That's actually the only ones I have.
Okay.
That I could get.
Oh, got it.
He gave me a Dropbox, but I don't have access to it.
Oh, that's all right. No problem. Well, yeah. We can show more, and he's going to be here. So, you know, and since I don't think we have any trailers today, do we?
Negative.
Yeah, well, you know, we were going to throw some trailers. But here's what we're going to go into next. And I know you have comments on this, because you've commented on this before. So I know I wasn't on here Monday. I had a tantrum and I walked off set. So it's just part of what I do. So I went to Comic-Con on Saturday. And to be honest with you, I thought it was going to be a lot worse than it really was. You know, I mean, I've been to Comic-Cons before where you can't walk. I mean, it's just shoulder to shoulder. And then it becomes like, I really can't see anything. It's just kind of done.
Mm-hmm.
But this was probably well laid out better.
Hmm.
And it was plenty of room. I mean, there was, I was walking with.
We have a video. to show, like, yeah, well, a few seconds?
Yeah, actually, show that video real quick, because that's us. Actually, we're leaving at this point in time, and everybody was queuing up for the all the stuff in the show. That lady was all happy about being on camera. That we were literally getting ready to leave, but they were queuing up for all the Q&As down below. I do have some shots. James, I think, did you get some shots of the high shots where I was showing the crowds?
Negative.
Well, the queue lines were pretty big.
Mm-hmm.
You get to go interact with, there was a whole bunch of people that I can't even remember who all was there. But I mean, Daryl from The Walking Dead was there. But
that's a big crowd.
That was a very big, and I do believe he showed up as we were leaving, because I heard a whole ton of people just cheering and yipping and
his hopping.
His
flight got delayed or something, and he got there late.
He must have flown Delta.
He got in, his arms were tired.
It wasn't Malaysian Air.
It could have been Malaysian Air. No, because then he would have never showed up. But I tell you, there was a ton of Harley Quinns. And we all knew
every
going
year
in that Harley Quinn and Deadpool and Spider-Man, those are typically the easiest ones. But this young lady here, in my opinion, was probably one of the best Harley Quinns there.
That's because I didn't go as Harley Quinn.
Well, I would take a picture of that.
I actually went as Harley Quinn to a Comic-Con.
I know. I've heard about that now. This was more of the Harley Quinn that we're used to out of the comics.
Mm-hmm.
Right?
Yeah. And heavy into the animations in Justice League and a few others that she's made appearances on.
This one right here, I took pictures of her, and she was next to the Batman. Or not the Batman, but
That's a really cool one.
And that's not bad. But she carried that thing around all day long. We saw her all day, but she swung around like it was nothing.
$5 says it's foam.
Foam. It looked good.
Yeah,
it really did. And then it was like a swarm of Deadpools. Deadpools and Spider-Man.
We call those goon squads.
There you go. So, I mean, they were everywhere. And then it was kind of funny. These guys were standing there, and next thing you know, a purple Deadpool walks up. And they're like, oh, Purple Deadpool, come on over this. And he joined the crowd, and I got a picture of him somewhere.
They just flock.
They do, man. Like, boom. And then there was, I think I got a picture of an original.
I don't see Purple Deadpool.
No, it's in the other pictures. I got it right here. But then there was a really good, like an Avengers.
Hmm.
Like the whole squad were there. I mean, including Loki, but Loki had boobs. And
I think I've seen that one before.
I'm accepting of Loki having boobs.
Well, show that one of the
gender swap
Avengers.
Loki. Wow. Okay.
Of what?
The Avengers. Did you not get that one?
Negative.
Well, I don't know if it could be a gender swap Loki, because Loki was a girl in the comics at one point.
That's what I thought. So, well, what's another picture you got, James?
I have the Jedis.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. This was. Do you have the whole sequence?
Yeah.
So these two people were walking down. We're like, hey, let's get a picture. So that happened, and the next thing you know, what walks up behind them? Here he comes. Yep.
The good
and
guys.
And boom. And watch. And I timed it just right to get it. And then it's like, okay, now it's a full on flight.
Oh, it was almost Order 66. It was almost the good guys.
I know. But it was good. I mean. And there was way more. There's a ton of pictures.
And then Kylo Ren showed up.
And Kylo Ren, and he's like,
"Did he throw a hissy fit?
I'm tired." No, I shouldn't say that, because that was actually a pretty good costume. Now, the one thing that I did get to meet is I got to meet Scott Finster, and he worked on The Walking Dead season 5.
Hmm.
This
and
guy,
that guy right there, and that is Walking Ted. Now, let me tell you something. We were at this booth there, Road to Sanctuary booth, and they had a guy there that looked, that's my best friend. That's what I look like in about 100 years. Anyway, we were there, and the two guys that they had in the booth to take pictures with was a lookalike, Rick Grimes and Abraham. And let me tell you something, dude. They look just like them. I mean, it was scary how the guy that played Abraham came out, and he was looking at this one lady next to him, and she's like, oh, I love you, and he went like this, you know, and I'm like, holy crap. I mean, he had the mannerisms. Yeah, he didn't break character to come out there, come out there and do it, but he looked just like him. But now, Scott, I'm not going to tell everybody where he lives, but he lives local enough that he said he would come in.
Oh, wow.
And they
awesome.
Have developed zombie food. Their toes and their fingers and their knuckles and their earlobes, and it's edible. It's jerky is what it really, I think is what it is. It's jerky.
Yeah.
So I'd eat it.
So, well, I'm hoping to get him in so he'll actually come in and bring the product with him, and we'll do, because, you know, Dead's coming back. So, you know, here's a picture of him that I got, right?
And, you know, signed and everything.
And then I got the Walking Ted, of course. It's like this. Anyway.
Oh, no, watch out, Superman.
So, to me, and that was probably very, very cool. And then I also got to meet the voice of Space Ghost. And I'm trying to find it. George Lowe. And I had him. He signed it. I don't know if you can get that, James, or not.
Yeah. I don't have a robotic.
Yeah, that's right. The robotic sign. So anyway, he signed it. Now, this dude.
It's not just any ghost.
Hilarious.
Space Ghost. Space Ghost. Coast to coast.
He re-signed it. Greetings, Nerd Talk citizens. Because I told him we did the show. It says, take that, processing multi-food. Leviconicalophopy. He was a riot. Space Ghost, try new Bugly Bass capsules. He's talking about, you know, the tree that you did, had no problem. he said, snack tip, boys and girls, bacon panties. I'm just saying. So, to me,
I'm okay with that.
To me, that was hilarious because it is what it is, and, you know. And so then, you know, not only did you get to see the interesting characters, who else we got as images there, James?
We have a Pokemon.
A Pokemon. Or a Pokegirl.
Pokegirl.
That wouldn't be a Pokemon. That would be a Pokegirl, in my opinion. I mean, I could be wrong. I don't know. You know, I'm just saying.
Well, Pokemon only is short for pocket monster. So technically, yeah, it's still just a Pokemon. Just a Flareon.
Oh, what is it called?
Flareon.
Flareon. It's a
you
pocket
sure?
monster.
Is that Flareon?
You know what we used to call pocket
yeah,
monster?
That's a Flareon.
Not that. Anyway.
So how many? Did you see more Harley Quinn and Jokers or more Pokemon?
More Harley Quinn and Jokers.
That's actually kind of surprising with Pokemon Go.
No, it's not.
Well, you know, I mean, you saw some, but some of the costumes for the Pokemon were so. It seems like they went and put some red and white on.
I was gonna say, here's the thing about is. Cosplaying Deadpool, they literally sell morph suits for $10. You slap
true.
The morph suit on, grats, your Deadpool.
Well, anyway, I tell you what, we have a couple of Jokers. I took a picture, you know, that we took a picture. Show the, yeah, I mean, he was actually a pretty good Joker.
That is a pretty
he's
good
got
Joker.
The suit, so yeah, that's I like mean, the hardest he, part.
He did.
Yeah, he's got those colors.
That's a Jack Nicholson.
Yes, exactly. And then we have the one that looked like, Heath
Ledger.
Oh my God! Yeah, Keith Ledger. So Keith. That one is if James has got that.
No,
one.
I don't have that one.
Ah, that was the one I really wanted to show. Doggone it! Yeah. Who else you got?
I have. One second. Let me adjust a size. It's too skinny. I'm trying to adjust it.
Oh, just show it like it is. It's all right.
It's another Harley Quinn.
Yeah. She turned at the last minute. I was taking a picture, and she looked the other way. So, and she was actually, she was a very good-looking girl. So, I have to say.
She didn't actually look the other way. You were just creeping.
No. I'm pretty blatant about taking your picture. I mean.
Some people at Comic-Con creep for you.
And now, this was funny. Okay. So. It's like, you know, I'm taking pictures of everybody, and my wife is okay with it. My wife was with me, and, you know, it's like, there was eye candy for her, just like, you know, this is eye candy for me. So this is, she goes, well, hey, if you use my picture, you know, post my blah, blah, blah. And I have a plus 18, and my wife said, no. So, not happening. Not that I haven't even been there. I didn't come to work and go, hey, I'm going to go there and whole nine yards. So, what's another picture you have there, Jane?
We have this.
Now, this is what I thought was very cool. There's a lot of families there, and they all, and it was, they did a really good job causing together.
Mm-hmm.
You know, so that to me, that was a pretty good. There's actually one I didn't get a picture of them that we talked to on the way in. That was part of. They were part of the Avengers crew that we didn't. Hmm. James didn't get a hold of. So,
but we have another Star-Lord that, or maybe the same one. This guy.
No, that's a different one.
It's a pretty good Star-Lord.
Yep. And then there was also, what's his name there?
Ronan.
Yeah, Ronan. The Ronan was okay. You know, he's supposed to have gloves on, though. Ronan had, yeah, had gloves, you know.
Ronan was also blue, and they dressed him in sand before they put him on, or put the armor on him, so.
Yeah. We also have, I think we have one Star-Lord and Groot.
There was a Groot?
There was a Groot. Dude, do we have all the pictures of Groot?
No.
Do you have any pictures of Groot?
I don't see any pictures of Groot.
Dude, it's in there.
That's the one. That one was
impressive.
If you
go look in that folder, it's in there because that guy was killer. And he was 7 feet tall. So here's the sad thing, everybody, is Dan here is going to get to see Groot and your guys are not.
No.
Now, and there's the Heath Ledger. You see, you guys can't see that, so.
Just a tease for him.
Yeah, Mom said, heck no. And then there was, now, do you have the Black Spider-Man?
Hey, you, stop it. Stop that.
And,
yes.
And Princess Diana?
Fine, I'll
yes.
stop
so,
you then.
Now, this one, okay, well, I wanted Princess Diana, not the guy.
What?
Yeah, it's out here. You can't see it, but anyway, she looked just like
Wonder Woman.
Yeah, but I'm trying to get girl. Gal Gadot. Yeah, she looked. She looked just kind of. You know, she had the same. It was very good. You don't got a wide doll of them, James, because you're not going to be able to see them if you do. There's the Avengers.
Such an issue with Gal Gadot. God.
Sorry, guys. I have I do have pictures. I don't know why James. It's in that folder inside the pictures file. So, but and then there was Michael Myers. You know, and there was Game of Thrones was big. Everybody was a Game of Thrones guy, person. And there's the Groot right there.
Jeez. By chance, see a giant doorstop?
I did not see a giant doorstop.
Very upset, man. Very sad.
Too soon.
Not soon enough.
It's never too soon. Too soon.
I don't get it. Doorstop.
No.
You have to hold the door.
Yeah, you know, normally when a character develops, they, you know, there's some kind of personal growth. He kind of grew backwards there into a doorstop.
Oh, I got it.
Hold
now,
the door.
See, there was another Harley Quinn. Oh, did you get the Harley Quinn and the Joker? I bet you didn't get her either, huh?
I'm looking.
So anyway, but. The artwork, so while James is looking for more stuff, so I started walking around and I got some killer artwork.
Yeah, this one's awesome.
Nice.
And then Batman just in there.
And then, nope. it's the oh God, the Beatles.
Abbey Road
version, right? Yeah, the guy that did this signed it, so I have that. And of course, for all you Lara Croft dudes,
I never saw that one.
Yeah, I know. I was hiding it from you.
Rightfully so.
It'll wind up being the bathroom. Now, this right here, I think, is the coolest. Give me a closer shot, James. Because that's Batman, Last Supper.
Oh, that's pretty sweet.
That's pretty cool.
That is very cool. And then, of course, I went, because, you know, Deadpool. If I could do that without it. So to me, that was pretty rad. I think Mark wants to take that and put it in his room.
No, Mark, you have a good night.
But anyway, and then in local news, Yankee Street Comics.
Don't do it, James.
Was there, and the guy that did their comic was there signing it.
Mm-hmm.
So
that's
it was
pretty awesome.
It was pretty good. Of course, you know, you got to get the.
We got Brandon back here.
No, I got it.
Okay.
So, you know, of course, then I picked up
Martin here.
Whole Tampa Bay Comic Con and
all of everything.
Wow, that was awesome, man. I got to hear that all the way over here.
That's a good working speaker.
Those speakers were great. So Tampa Bay Comic Con was actually pretty stinking good.
It looked a lot less crowded than the last time I went, which is the whole reason I won't go.
And I did have shots in there. I don't know why James didn't pull them. He just doesn't like
his people.
Because I'm so mean.
God, the group was awesome.
But I mean, there was even a Groot. Yeah.
Groot.
I mean, the dude. He was walking on, you know, painter stilts. So I think is what they are, or drywall stilts.
Yeah, probably.
There was even a Sigourney Weaver in there. There was, try to find that Heath Ledger lookalike.
Yep.
Because to me, and don't worry about resizing, just put them up.
I got to turn them around.
Oh, that's right.
They're upside down.
It's for some reason, when you do an iPhone into a PC, it flip-flops everything. So sorry we're not so prepared tonight.
Because everything on Mac is flip-flopped.
Yeah.
That one?
Yeah, I mean, to me, that was a good Heath Ledger one. You know, he's got the hair, he's got the look. You got the outfit. It's pretty cool, you know. So, but anyway, there's tons in there. I do have some pictures in there, James, of the crowd up in the beginning, in the areas.
Yeah.
Which are really good. Oh, there was that's a dude.
Yeah, they tried to pull that one on me.
Yeah, that was a dude. But anyway, that was pretty good. So. I can't wait for next year. Or before I left, I talked to him about having Nerd Talk there.
Wow, your cosplay looks really, really good.
Thanks, bro.
Yeah.
Here's the crowds.
That. Yeah, I mean, it wasn't, but that was a queue line. So that really wasn't that bad. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, I went last year and it was just terrible because it was so just overcrowded. Like, it was shoulder to shoulder. I showed up at, I got there about 10:30.
Purple Deadpool.
I got there about 10:30, and I was actually going to buy one of the signings.
Right.
Because they had the guy who did the voice of Vegeta from Dragon Ball Z.
Right.
And I'm a huge DBZ fan.
Huge?
Huge!
It's huge, Tampa, huge.
And I showed up at 10:30 for a 1 o'clock signing, and they were already turning people away.
God,
it was shoulder to shoulder through the whole floor. The vending machines had about a 45-minute wait.
Yeah, you know, it was kind of funny. The people we went with friends of ours, the D'Agostinos. Yo, what's up, boys? And you know, we decided halfway through, you know what? Let's go get something to eat. We walked over to the line and said, "Nope, not."
Yeah, you don't eat at Comic Cons. It's expensive.
Yeah, it says
and
the price.
So then we said, "Well, hey, you know what? They had food trucks.
See this
out
Flareon.
Front, huh?
It's Flareon.
It is Flareon. Yep." So we said, okay, well, hey, let's go out to the front because they had food trucks out, right? Go out there, $10 for a hamburger. Now look, folks. All right, soapbox. I need to have a, you know, James. We're gonna make a graphic, and we're gonna put a I have my head on top of a soapbox and John's soapbox. Just because you can go to an event. That there's a tons of people and you know they have to eat, don't stick it to them.
I mean, you'd probably almost make more money probably selling them at $5.
I mean, look, I guarantee you there's no hamburger that's worth freaking $10. I don't give a crap who makes it.
I've never had mine.
Yeah.
Never had mine.
Hamburger is hamburger and you can put crap in it all day long, but it ain't worth no $10.
I don't know. Mine's pretty good.
Ain't no
James,
$10, dude.
Image of
you know what? I'd never find out because I wouldn't pay $10 for it.
Image of what?
Heart Attack Cafe in, I think it's Nevada.
Nah.
Well, yeah, but that is not a hamburger. That is like
that is many
five hamburgers. That's different.
Five.
But for me to sit down and have a single hamburger on two pieces of bun with some stuff on it, I ain't paying $10. I ain't doing it.
Yeah.
So,
that is a little expensive.
It's crazy. So, and that's just hamburger. Mm-hmm. That's not your drink. That's not your French fries. That's that, you know, $6 French fries. Potatoes, boys. They're potatoes. Come on, seriously. They're potatoes.
Don't trash talk potatoes.
So you leave potatoes alone.
The Irish guys here.
I ain't paying no $6 for potatoes. Unless they're covered in cheese and bacon, sour cream, and jalapenos. I mean, you got to make
it worth a lot.
You got an
issue with potatoes, too?
I'm not, but for just a normal thing of potatoes,
yeah.
I ain't paying $6. So anyway, so we walked out there. We're like, well, good God Almighty, what are we going to do? So what do? We walked across the street to the hotel, and they had a Starbucks there. So we figured, well, we'll get a snack in Starbucks.
Only slightly overpriced food.
No, but we never made it to Starbucks because out front, smart hotel, hamburger, bag of chips, bottle of water or soda, $6. That place was jammed.
I'll guarantee it.
And the burgers were, oh, there we go. Soapbox. But that, you got to put that in the middle, though. Anyway, so it was, it was a good burger. They grilled it right there in front of you, the whole nine yards, and put a little crap on it, blah, 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 whatever it is you have on there, I don't care. I know there's purists out there, mustard versus ketchup versus mayonnaise, mustard, none of it, versus blah, blah, blah. But it was really good. So then it gave us a little more energy. Then we walked back in and walked around. Now, there was a company there, and I don't know if James got this or not, that Hobbit Swords, they're the one that actually make the Game of Thrones sword replicas.
You had me at Hobbit.
Well,
more curious when you said sword.
Well, you know, Hobbit Swords, and now they're out of Chattanooga.
This right? one?
Yes. So, see, they're out of Chattanooga. It's actually called Valrillion.
Valrillionsteel.com. They have incredible.
They were there. You're talking about the coolest dudes, man.
Really?
Very cool. I talked to the owner, or one of, and I told him, and they're out of Chattanooga. I said, hey, look, you know, I come up all the time because my father lives up there. Not in Chattanooga, but right out of Chattanooga. Mm-hmm. I said, I'd love to come in and do an interview. He goes, all right, man, just give me a call. You can't just drop in because we got to know. I'm like, I can do this. And then, I think.
You mean you can't just drop into like a blacksmith shop and just talk to them?
No, you can't.
Why not?
I don't know.
It's almost like they have work to do.
So what I'm going to do is actually we're going up the weekend after the 1st of September because my dad's birthday is August 30th. And we're going to go up and see him. And I'm taking a camera. I'm going to do an interview while I'm up there.
Yeah, their stuff's incredible. I'm a huge Game of Thrones fan. And
they're the actual size, a whole nine yards.
They sell Damascus versions of swords. They do a lot of the ones differ from the description in the book versus the show.
Right.
So they have like Ice is the sword of Neddard Stark.
Right.
They have the movie, the show version.
She was there.
Yeah.
She was almost. Don't take the picture down. Put the picture back up. Someone told me, now in the show, that guy is dead.
No.
He didn't get eaten by something or killed by something? Oh, so.
Not that guy.
Okay. Now there was
this guy, 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 this guy.
It's easier to say who hasn't died.
Yeah. Okay. Those ones got eaten. We're not even getting to fire yet.
So now I think James has found all my pictures, thank God. Show the Sigourney Weaver one. You know which one that is? She's underneath the gourmet.
Yeah, no, I know.
So they're setting her costume up. She came in and the guy's buckling her up. But I thought that was, you know, she's you know, driving the loader, which I thought was, now that's
very,
that's unique. Pretty cool, because that's something that takes a little bit of thought process to try to figure out how to build. And man, she looked just like Sigourney Weaver. It was almost scary that she did. Show the prison, show the full size of the prison, if you don't mind, James, if you can get that one in there. Upside down, right side up, whole nine yards. Because I know I'm spending a little more time on the con. And Dylan's got something about some game that came. I don't know. Some kind of.
Here's the prison.
Yeah, to me that's pretty cool. You know, and you see Abraham and Rick back there, kinda. That's kind of what I was trying to get, is that picture.
That's pretty cool, though.
I'm telling you, man, it was pretty rad. So here's what
there's Sigourney Weaver.
There she is.
Hmm. Actually, that's quite the
elaborate costume.
Yeah, it is. I mean, and when she was, I tried to go back and get her because I got her as she walked, as she got all the loader stuff on, and it was pretty cool. I'm like, that's pretty rad. That's pretty good. So, I know. I guess there's some game to come out.
Yeah, World of Warcraft.
What is World of Warcraft?
Crack.
World of what craft?
World of what?
Yeah, it's drugs on a computer.
It's like crack for players?
Yeah. Well, it was. Now it's
Have you beat it already? It's boring.
I may have max level gear already.
Must be nice, because...
See, that's one game. My qualm with Pokemon Go is you can't say the cliche, go outside.
Because I am going outside.
Exactly.
Yeah, with WoW, it's
go outside.
That only took me 2 days, though. It wasn't very hard.
Supposedly, someone already beat No Man's Sky in 2 days.
Yeah, No Man's Sky. 18 quintillion planets. Yeah, 18 quintillion planets.
It must have been pretty boring if you're that good to beat all those planets.
No, we're all assuming that he completely avoided all the planets. He didn't land. He just went... He landed to get fuel and to repower the ship, and then immediately just took off again and did not explore in the slightest, which
boring
means...
Boring game.
Well, didn't I hear somebody beat Pokemon already?
Sort of. You can't beat it, you can get everything.
I would say he has 148.
So that means the guy didn't sleep, didn't eat, didn't poop, didn't go to work.
How did he get 148?
So he's homeless.
Probably.
But he's chasing Pokemon!
Hey, but he's got enough to pay his phone.
Yeah. Wow. Oh, that's right, because you got to have that bad boy, huh?
Yeah.
He caught everything except Ditto, Mew, Mewtwo, and the three legendary birds, which... Oh. Actually, so I guess it's 144?
No, it's 148. There's 152 with Mew and Mewtwo.
Articuno, Zapdos, and Moltres are in the 150.
Yeah.
They're not above the... Because Mew and Mewtwo are the last two in the set, and it's 150 and 151.
Oh.
So
well, then he got like 146.
All of them but six. So yeah, 144. My math is right. Because Ditto doesn't have a catch rate yet. Well, actually, now it does, but it's...
Ditto. I have no idea.
Do you know
it's
what
a
Ditto
little
is?
Pink blob.
It's supposedly a failed experiment of Mew.
Supposedly.
Mew and Ditto are the only two Pokemon in the entire game that can learn Transform.
Oh.
Which mimics the Pokemon you're fighting.
I transform.
And roll out?
Yep.
So, what about the game for that weird WoW? What?
Yeah, World of Warcraft. Legion didn't drop yet, but it announced their Demon Hunter class, and they allowed the people who pre-ordered to play their Demon Hunters, which is my Demon Hunter as of right now. Demon Hunters consist of a DPS spec.
It's just standing there.
You know, this is me just showing off what it looks like for now, because I'm about to activate Metamorphosis, which is one of the demon abilities that is exclusive to Demon Hunters, where we turn into our full-blown demon state.
You look horny to me.
Just wait.
Yeah, no, you say you don't know horny.
Oh, it's going to get worse. Oh, yeah. Hello!
So you pretty much just hulk out and... Yeah.
Not bad.
He is a fun time to play.
Still World of Warcraft.
Still World of Warcraft, yes. But I love this. I love the moveset. I like how tanky I am. Oh, God, this is a great expansion so far. Keep in mind, this is only... The full expansion isn't released yet. That comes out the 30th of August. For right now, though, they gave us our Demon Hunters, which is the new class that's being introduced. And it's so far I've had nothing but fun.
Are you a vampire? Because you're all sparkly.
Demon Hunter.
Get it?
I mean,
vampire, sparkly. All right, never mind.
Never heard of it.
Oh, no, we understand, but we just kind of ignore bad jokes.
Oh, that's just wrong.
That's my favorite.
Well, I ignore bad movies.
I love that cut. Because right there, right as I try to jump off that cliff, I realized that the jump has a longer cooldown than I expected, and I immediately face planted and died.
Oh, wow.
That's Demon Sight, allows you to see through walls and see enemies. That's comparing the male and the female Demon Hunters. Now, because the female does have a different form, which I thought was really interesting because it made it a lot thinner. And then, yeah, then there's back in human form.
Abazi Dirty.
Oh, that's the guild name, yeah, it's Dirty.
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 Yes. Well, So this is the other half they announced or they released with the Demon Hunters is the invasions.
Hey, is this the game that Howard Wolowitz?
Hold on.
Was
now, those little marks there are the invasion markers. Those show certain zones that are being invaded right now by the Legion, so you have to go there and help fend that off. So there, I flew into the zone, and the stage popped up. Stage 1 out of 4. Technically, there's only 3, but the 4th is to kill the final, is the raid boss, pretty much. So right now, it's me flying over the zone. You see the portals messing up. You see fell fire dropping from the sky. Game of Thrones fan, no green fire. Oh, too well. And then, yes, this is the big raid boss. These are the raid boss fights. They're not super tough. They're relatively easy to bring down. Level 100, 660 gear can bring it down, which is pretty low right now. In this, I'm running my eye level currently is 700. And the weapons I'm using are both 725, which is cap right now.
So what happens? A bunch of the guys that really know what they're doing go in there and beat them up, and then at the last minute everybody else runs in and goes, "Oh, we won!"
No, it's the people with the higher level gear and the tank specs, which is what I am right now, go and we do what's called grab aggro. In other words, we let that thing beat on us while everyone tries to deal as much damage as possible before we die or we have to end up backing off and healing ourselves. Now, normally there's more than one tank, so we all can grab aggro and it won't actually finish an attack.
We fried every one of you.
No, that was a team buff someone put down. But we all have increased stats at the moment. But yeah, this is the WoW that I really, the part that I really like about it, is you just see everyone there working together to bring something down. That thing has, I think it was 7 billion health, and was gaining a million health every 5 seconds. Like an additional million health that we had to cut through.
So you just won? Is that what it is?
No, that was only the start of it. Now I have to, there's little skulls on the map that I'm actually pinging using the awesome Bandicam editing software, recording software. Now you spread out, you go and try and force the Legion out of certain areas. This is this zone 3. I sped this up because this is...
Holy cow!
That was at Whirlwind, and I thought that was a hilarious effect, so I left that in. It's just a matter of you keep going from boss to boss to boss to boss. Everyone's flying around, working together. You see everyone just a flood of dragons and birds and all sorts of things.
I saw a dog in there.
Yeah, people ride their... there's flying dogs and whatnot. And everyone's just charging right back into the fight. I went to help this guy out, missed my jump, then realized he's fine because he half hit it at some point. And now we're all looking at the raid boss. We're waiting for him to land. They showed him on the map a little preemptively, but that's fine for us. So you see us all just kind of waiting down there, and he's, "I'll deal with you myself," as there's literally 80 of us on the ground ready to take care of him.
Seems a little one-sided.
Once again, 7 billion health. And you watch him just immediately lose that health bar go down.
Seems a little one-sided.
So that was after the fact. We had cleared him out, and now we're kind of just messing around waiting for the fourth stage to start, which is the demon commander. This is where people die. This is where if you have 660 gear and you don't have your max gear yet, or you're still trying to work on it, this is the part I would say be careful, because if you're a squishy mage, you're gonna get blown up.
Squishy mage.
Mage.
Mage. I was like, mage. I'm like, what?
When we use the word squishy, we mean you're not tank. You're not there to beef damage.
He fell on you.
I have a tank, it's fine. I hop my dragon and hop and ride off. Back to the big portal of doom, because that's where the final boss, the Legion Commander, is, the Demon Lord. Yeah, if you are not high level, good with your rotation, or just you don't watch your health, I suggest just being very careful in here, because you'll die really quickly. If you noticed throughout a lot of the other fights but previous to this, I didn't take very much damage. I lost maybe a quarter of my HP, and I healed it back relatively quickly just through Demon Hunter specs. This boss nearly killed me twice in this fight. I think, yeah, I sped it up a little bit, and you just kind of see us all hacking away at her. She had, I think it was 13 billion health to cut through.
Are you saying billion?
Billion, yes. If I were to put my mouse over her, that little green bar up there, that would say 17,000K.
How do you even know where you're at?
Yeah, that's what I'm saying.
So messed up.
We have a lot of people like download their mods. I turned all of my overlays, my mods off for this.
So you don't see all them? You just see you?
I see my name tag specifically. I stand out. I'm a different color.
Also, when you play the game, you kind of...
Yeah,
get used to it. I used to play.
Where you are at all
times.
Did
you used to play?
Yeah. And then they came out with pandas, and I was like, no.
Pandas are great. Don't even.
I tried to play. I got to level 6.
They're all almost level 11
now. Yeah, I started
to
play, and then I found girls.
Yes.
I'm married.
You found those a little late, huh?
Yes, I did.
Yeah, because this came out in like 2005.
Yeah.
Yeah. No. This was. My health just keeps dropping throughout this fight. I got lucky and got hit into the building. I think if I actually hit the ground there, I would have died. But I ended up just jumping right back in. God,
I was playing Pong. and then I found girls.
Keep in mind, this is sped up 150%, and she still just keeps wailing on us. These bosses have a lot of... I at first thought that maybe we didn't have, like, not everyone made it yet, and I thought our damage was just lower, and then I realized she killed half of us in her first three attacks. Oof. So she finally went down. You see people like her, like, you know, the little green names, like, randomly appearing. I was lagging really bad.
That was way too easy. I'm not even go there on that one.
All right, then. And then
that was an Aerosmith song.
At the end of the
elevators and all. Sorry, son.
At the end of the invasion, despite the talking over me, you do cycle through two boxes, and those have drops in them. The drops contain nether shards, which is the way to get the better gear, or you can use the gear they drop. All the gear they drop is 700 gear, so if you're still at 660 and you're still climbing up, it'll put you to 700 really quickly. I think I did 7 invasions on Thursday on my day off. And
how long did that take?
How long did it take? Well, there's 2 invasions, and the invasions happen every 3 hours and 40 minutes. So I would just kind of jump back between regions, and then I'd get off for a couple hours, come back on, there'd be another invasion, I go to the invasion, get off, and repeat the process. After rinsing and repeating for enough times, and get the achievement for doing all 6 invasions that they have out right now, then you should have your gear should be at 700. I think I'm at 701 right now.
Get footage of No Man's Sky?
No, No Man's Sky decided that, hey guys, we're gonna release our game that we said we got August 12th. We're gonna release that August 12th, 6 p.m. UK time.
So midnight tonight?
No, it's 1 o'clock this afternoon is when it came out. I'm like, why? That's in the middle.
You know, why not?
If they had released it last night at midnight, I could have just stayed up tonight recording and then slept tonight. But so, now I've got to stay up tonight and record.
So you're telling me that WeBeam TV or Nerd Talk needs to have an official gaming computer here that everybody come in, log in on, and play?
I mean, you could just go home and watch Nerd Talk stream on Twitch, perhaps, even. Because I can probably be streaming live there.
You gonna do that tonight?
Yes, I sure can. I can do Twitch. That as soon as I get home.
Max Play Live.
No Man's Sky.
Actually, we need to do a Nerd Talk live on a Nerd Talk on Twitch.
Well, you know.
Never mind. They kind of tie our hands on what we can do, because we are a television station and we do run commercials, because that's how we pay for all this wonderful content that 5 people are watching right now. So
there's more than that.
And we thank those 5 people.
And we love those 5 people.
Hey, I'm usually one of those 5 people.
So
we lost a viewer today.
Oh,
thanks,
really?
Dan.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Dan, you're killing me, man.
So 4. Because, yeah, you know, you're on set.
Now, we have some really cool stuff, and I'm going to start promoting it now, and I think my sign is over there. We have FusionCon coming.
FusionCon!
September 17th, 11 a.m. to 7 p.m. It's a comic book convention. It's going to be at the Newport Richey Aquatic Center. Is it going to be pretty big?
I'm pretty excited for it. I'm starting to ponder what I'm going to cosplay. Really? I got a few different ideas.
Nerd Talk's going to have a panel there. I guess we're going to do our show from there. Our D&D game, the island, is going to be there. And then I think we were going to start a gaming tournament, but it looks like we're going to have to hold off till January. Mm. I really wanted to start it now, but it looks like, because we're super busy, and I want to do this right, and I want to make sure everybody gets, you know, we get enough people into it, which we already had people like, oh, we want in, but I had to hold off because we're just crazy busy here. Studio's growing. We're getting into the whole new sports side of it that we haven't even talked about yet, but we will eventually. That is going to be an awesome event. Now, if you were watching before and you watch Card Subject to Change and you're a good viewer, Then the guy that was on the two hosts for Card Subject to Change run the FusionCon.
And Ray.
Mark.
Yeah, Mark. Yeah, I don't say his last name because I really like Mark, and I don't.
And it's Mark Karoftis.
Karoftis, right?
Yes.
He has actually become our web guru here in the studio.
Hmm.
So if you come to Tampa Bay Multimedia, which who owns WeBeam TV, Whole Nine Yards, we actually have brought Mark into the fold because Mark's a phenomenal web guy. I mean, really, really good. I mean, don't get me wrong, we do good work, but it comes to a point in time you gotta pick and choose what you want to do. So, and on top of that, he's a killer graphic artist.
Mm.
So we get about the best of both worlds. Okay. So with that being said, stay tuned on Monday. I'm not sure, you know, we might even do some highlights of the Olympics because that is going on.
The Olympics, that's pretty big.
And Michael Phelps has done well. Lily did well.
21 gold medals.
First person to do that. Now. Yeah, first person to do that since 22, ancient Greece.
22, yeah.
2100
I think it's 22,
years.
Yeah. I mean, Monday, we will know for fact on Monday. And then, of course, our mall location is coming along very shortly because we'll be doing some shows up at the Gulfview Mall. With that being said, oh, yeah, I'll tell you all about that.
Yeah.
With that being said, I am John Gaston. I am Boss Tech. This is Dylan Gaston Sidekins. This is Dan. Say your last name, Dan.
McConaughey.
Because I know if I did that, I would mess it up. I'm very bad with names. I don't know why.
Oh, it's a mouthful.
And anyway. Back in the back is James Hunsbugger, better known as Utatech.
Or Sausage Link.
Artilla the Huns.
Artilla the Huns, yes.
Sausage Link.
And Oratech, we hope he gets better. And unfortunately, Darth Maul is working right now. So we have a whole lot of stuff we got to get done. So with that being said, we will see everybody Monday at 6:30. And you guys have a wonderful weekend.